say thank you.
Please go and encourage somebody for a few moments. Someone that you did not come with. Encourage them, let them know it's so good to see them. Amen.
Keep up the good job.
want to remind you, first of all, I want to put this right on your mind, the first thing this morning. Don't forget this evening at 3:30 p.m., I will be speaking, and the singers will be singing. I will be speaking at Living Waters International Apostolic Ministries, 7802 Jensen Drive. Again, Living Waters International Apostolic Ministries, 7802 Jensen. If you're not familiar with Jensen, if you would just get on 59 and go north, south, like you're going to town, exit the Cross Timbers exit. When you exit Cross Timbers, turn right. Go down to Cross Timbers to Jensen Drive, make a right turn on Jensen Drive, and just go down about maybe past that first block. You're gonna see a car wash and wash chair right down the right. Soon as you pass it, the church is right there to your right. Again, the name of the church is Living Waters International Apostolic Ministries, 7802 Jensen. That's at 3:30 today. I will be bringing a message. Also, I would like to meet with all the ministers immediately after service. I'd like to meet with you in my office. So we can go over only about 2 or 3 minutes, 5 minutes of your time. Then we'll be out of there. We can go home and get ready for this afternoon. Okay, our program is printed. The announcements is on it. I think it would be redundant for me to go back over them again. So please go ahead and read the announcements that's on there. We want to give kudos to everyone, to Sister Dahlia Renee, who graduated with her master's, Lori graduated, and also Sister Latoya graduated with her master's. Man, so we want to encourage you all. We want you to know that we love you all, that God bless you all, make a positive impact in this world. I wish all of you all were here Wednesday night. I just want to encourage you to come out on Wednesday nights while we're still in this series, Detoxing Our Spirits. If you did not catch last Wednesday, I would encourage you to go to YouTube, The Bishop 46, and pull up last Wednesday's Bible study. We was talking about positive, powerful words. In fact, the whole message title was Developing Positive, Powerful, Impacting Words. It is a teaching that will change your life. We're detoxing our spirits. So always remember, it's what you say out of your mouth. So, okay, again, thank you all for your help for the food pantry. The next one won't be until June. So we're also getting ready for our guest that's coming in June the 1st, Bishop West. This is during the pastor and wife appreciation service. So at 3:30 p.m., the first Sunday in June is Bishop West. Then that Friday night is going to be Pastor Tucker. And then that second Sunday, we're closing out at 3:30 p.m. So we look forward to having you there. Let's give everybody who made the honor roll a hand clap. Job well done to our women, our ministry. But I have to throw that butt in there, Brother Dana, because you got to always keep them off track a little bit. It was wonderful, but I want you ladies to take some of what you got out of it and utilize it. Utilize it. All right? So we thank God for that. All right. Well, again, we want to remember those that's on our comfort and strength list. You know, when you guys pray, please remember them. We still have other people that's in college and school, so let's please remember them as well. If anyone is celebrating a birthday, anniversary, or special day this month, we give you a hand clap of kudos. God bless you. Man, God bless you. So again, we thank God for you. We're glad that, you know, you made your traveling safe. This is our morning service. We're moving, we're flowing with the service. So if you need to get my attention with something, please tell a usher and they will come up to me. We're gonna move move straight on through our service. So we thank God for everything that is going on, and we thank God for all of you. Amen. So this morning, Minister Evangelist Alice, come on, take your post. She's going to be bringing the word this morning. Amen. Also, ladies and gentlemen, we want you to know that also the Holy Convocation is coming up. Please, if you want to register, go ahead and register early. We're going to be, every night is going to be here. It's the youth night is Wednesday, then we got Thursday, Friday, and Saturday. And then that Sunday, we're going to close out at the Sheraton JFK. Now, the registration is only for that Sunday, and that's for the dinner. If you want to eat, that's for the dinner that we're going to eat after the service. So we still have a long ways to go, but a short time to get there. I don't have those announcements. Yes, I do. I do have that one that's not on the program that I really need you all to heed to. I think, Brother Dale, you sent it to the bishop's email, right? Okay, let me see if I can find it. If not, we're going to move on. I don't want to delay any part of God's services with a whole lot of bombard announcements. You know, I'm trying to give you young a lot of things. So anyway, but just live in your ear. We have the youth practice for the praise dancers. That's young teens and younger. It's going to be June the 14th. June the 28th, write it down. We're going to also have it announced again July the 12th, July the 26th. Each one of those rehearsals are on a Saturday, and they're going to be at 11 a.m. for the praise dancers. This is for all of our youth in the fellowship is going to be getting together, and they're going to praise dance. They're going to praise dance for that Wednesday for the youth night. And the Wednesday night youth night going to be crunk. I mean, they got all the rappers in place, and everybody's just ready. So Wednesday night is youth night. After the youth night, they're going to dance again that Sunday. They're going to dance while the singers are singing. And when the singers get through singing, they're going to do their final dance, all right? I expect every person that's on that is in ministry, if you are a deacon, deaconess, minister of whatever capacity, make sure you are in your garment. That is your attire. You know, your tab collars, your full collar, okay? For that Sunday. We always dress in attire for that Sunday. So I'm trying to work on a photographer. I'm trying to contact a friend of mine, but I'm trying to work on it because I need to check on some things. I'm trying to see if I can get him to come out to do us some photo shoots for that particular day on that Sunday. It's very important that you be on time. I'm going to be giving with the staff here for the set up everything over there. So we're going to set up, we're going to go there and set up everything. Hopefully they'll let us set it up the night before. If not, we'll have to get there early and you all can get it set up. Okay? So we're looking forward to that. It's going to be such a blessed time in the Lord on that. So that's for the youth praise dance. The adult choir practice, that's for teens and adults, is going to be, Bishop Powell is going to be heading that again this year, July the 17th through the 25th, 6:30 p.m. Both rehearsals will be here. Everything is here. And then we have the adult and youth practice going to be a run-through, August the 2nd at 11 a.m., okay? So also to our musicians, I'm expecting you guys to take the lead. There are going to be a couple other musicians, but I've already told them that our musicians take the lead on everything. So I want to make sure of that. So put those dates down. That's what we're getting ready for our holy convocation. So we thank God for that as we get ready, to get those things done, okay? And this is something that is very dear to me, and I hope it's dear to you, because just like the church, Heart of Faith is dear to me, Faith Fellowship is dear to me also. Both of them are visions that were birthed, and we're moving forward. We thank God for it, okay? Next year I'm going to be, well not next year, but I'm going to be doing some things different. Adding some people to staff, doing some things here and there in both organizations, in Heart of Faith and in Faith Fellowship. We already have people that's coming in that's joining the fellowship. So Now it's time to kind of get things to rolling, all right? All right, if there be nothing else, if you, most of you who ordered your shirts, the second round of your church shirts, as soon as they get in, I will let them know. But if you want to go ahead and pay, please go ahead and pay, but put it on your envelope to let them know this is for your church shirt and the amount, okay? Now, the purple, right? Specify if it's the women's t-shirt or the church t-shirt. You got a purple one for the men and a green one for the women. But please do not substitute your tithes for your shirts. Amen? I know how it goes. I've been there too. Y'all know how you do it. I just can't stand to give all the tithes and pay for a shirt. I'm going to pay for the shirt. Don't cheat God. Amen? I tell you, Deacon Brown would tell you, it is not worth cheating God, is it? It pays off when you are, yes. God will open up windows. I'm telling you, if you all want to experience it, that's why I tell you, take what I'm teaching, put it into practice. If you want to experience God's greatness for your life, if you're satisfied where you're at, then keep doing what you're doing. If you want to go to that next dimension in God, then you got to be willing to trust God all the way. When you trust God all the way, God will open up the window and God will do things for you that you cannot imagine of things, So I'm telling you, so trust God. That's all I can tell you. I can't make you, I can't force you. I'll put it out there. It's up to you all what you do with it, But I can tell you one thing. As for me, I can't make my wife, I can't make my children, my mama, my grandkids. But as for me, I have my relationship with God, and I'm following what God is saying. All right. There be nothing else. We thank God for you lending me your ear. Now at this time, we are ready to go to another part in the worship service. And this part in the worship service is the most, I'm going to say this. It's going to sound controversial. But before you take it controversial, listen to the whole statement. This next part we're about to do is the most highest and greatest part in worship that you can do. No, it is not hearing the preaching. The preaching is not the greatest part in worship. We say that because it's the word. The word of God is the word of God. The greatest and the most highest and the most powerful part in worship is the part that we actually become a doer. Jesus said, don't just be a hearer, but be a doer. So that means doing exceeds hearing. So this next part that we all can participate as we give unto the Lord. Amen? Amen. Amen. That's what you ought to be excited about. It's when you give unto the Lord. Amen? So whatever you do, don't hold back, but give unto God and trust God. Amen? All right. As our brethren come, and once you give, please, if you need prayer, do not leave. Once you give, just join us here at the altar. Amen? Amen. See, I've learned those principles is that when you cheat God, you're really cheating yourself. And that's not nothing to be hocus pocus to try to get finances from you. Trust me, God has touched people's heart, and they're just giving into the ministry. Amen? Do want you to know good news, and I'm not going to say, and please don't let anyone else say what the devil meant. But no, the devil ain't got nothing to do with this. We just got evil-minded people. So you all know the grass is not cut because they stole the old lawnmower, and that was fine because we was in the market to get another one. So now we got a new one, a bigger and a better one, more commercial. So the babies will be open Monday. So please forgive us of the yard. He will be on it Monday, and the yard will be taken care of. Amen? Amen. All right. So sometimes things just have to happen, Brother Harry, and we can go and move forward. Because I knew we needed one, but I kept saying, you know what? We just keep running this one until it's just at the end. So since they took it, then we have no other choice. Amen? All right. Please stand to your feet. Holy Father, in Jesus' name, we thank you, God. We declare that we are blessed because you have blessed us, God. Because you have blessed us, no one can curse us. God, we stand today to obey your word. God, we sow our seeds into your kingdom and appoint unleash your trust. This is where your circumstances, listen to me carefully, your problems, your heartaches, your pain, your suffering, your downs, this is where all of that you are no match for, listen to these words carefully, it meets its match this morning. And the match is the power of Jesus Christ. Your circumstances, your problems, your illness, your sicknesses are no match for Christ. Amen. So as Elder Ramsey come, I want you to trust God. Because sometimes we know there's no match.
Amen. Father, we come this morning giving thanks and praise you. Father, thank you for waking us up this morning. Gathering us on our way, Father. Thank you for guiding us back to the house of the Lord. Thank you for all your good and divine blessings. Thank you for everything, Father. Because, Father, you have been so much, Father, that you could not for yourself, Father. You owe everything to you. Father, say thank you. Thank you for everything, Father. Bless us. Let's afflict us. Let's warm up all in the world, Father. Bless each and every one that I have offered this morning, Father. Father, you know that they want, you know they concern, you know all things about them. Father, your words that ask, and you shall do. Father, we give you all the thanks and all the praise, Father. Bless each and every one that's here, Father. Bless each and every one that's on their way. Bless everyone, because Father, we all stand in need of the holy divine blessing. We just give you all the thanks, all the praise. Father, these blessings are in your son, Jesus' name. Thank you.
He was a chief tax collector in the region. and he had became very rich. He tried to get a look at Jesus. That brother was tired of what he was doing. He was tired. I want to talk to you about this man. Let me share something with you about the city first. Jericho was a city, I'm sorry, you can be seated. Jericho was a city of resort, something like New Orleans and Vegas and Houston. A lot of stuff went on there. But Jesus' family, 3 days from the cross, he was destined to die for our sins. I say 3 days. He could have took a shortcut. He could have said, I don't want to go through that mess. But 3 days. 3 days, family, from the cross. He was destined to do that for us. So he ran ahead, okay. There was the tax collectors. Zechariah was a short man. He was very short. But there he ran ahead. You know how when we were young, we go to parades,
right,
and we wait on the bands to come through, especially our school bands. And boy, we be trying to hear it and see it. But it's this one somebody that walks ahead of the band by himself with his cape on. And he step high and he hold his head high.
Yeah.
He be about his business.
Yeah.
I think they call him a drum major.
Yeah.
Everybody wanna see that drum major.
Yeah. Yeah.
But in this case, the keys wanna see Jesus. My brother was too short to look over Beverly. Oh, Brother Harry, like me, I can't stand by my husband and see nobody. I got to get walking on his side.
Okay.
I want you to know that just like coincidence, there was a tree there, a sycamore tree. Let me tell you about this tree.
Come on here.
Let me tell you about this tree.
Yeah.
I want you to stay focused, young people. I'm going to say family. Stay focused. This tree, I'm going to build this tree for you. I'm going to do this right now. These trees are very beautiful.
All right.
The bark, but wait, let me back up. This tree is beautiful, but it don't have the ability to stand up against the weather and storms like other trees that live for hundreds of years. The leaves is wide.
Come on, yeah.
But the tree ain't no use. It's useless if it's not abused. I want you to know that a sycamore tree, before it bear produce figs, it have to be abused. I think that's something like us. Before God can use us, we have to be abused. I'm just keeping it real, family. We have to be abused. If we wasn't, we would never call on. Remember, right about it. If we had what we wanted, would we call on? Would we be here today? I don't think so.
Come on now.
But because my little brother, Zechariah, wanted to see him, he climbed.
Yeah.
In the tree, because the leaves, tell you, leaves are sycamore trees. Growth started growing, I want to say, about 3 feet from the ground. What another coincidence. The tree is there, this short man, and...
Come on.
But the tree have ability to grow as high as 75 to 100 feet.
Okay.
So he could get up there and see his drum major. No one that was taking it off. I don't know if you remember, but I remember the band be back there, the drum baby be up there, my head be like this, and I'm listening back there. I want you to know that I believe in my heart, Zacchaeus was tired, just like a lot of us. We get into situations or we allow certain things to get us in it. I can't say it, we go ahead. We allow ourselves to get in situations and we get tired. But we don't know how to pull out. But when somebody told you that somebody was coming through, that brother did what he had to do to get up there to see it. And when Jesus, in verse 5, when Jesus came by, he looked up at Zacchaeus and called him by name. Jesus can call you by your name while you're shaking. He know your name. He know you. He know you. And what I like about it, he said, quick, come down. Jesus was on a mission, destined to die for our sins. Salvation was there. He said, come down, quick. That word quick meant, come on, this is, we got to do this. Come on now, brother. I don't know if it meant before we mess up again, come on or what. But he said, quick, come down. And then guess what he said? This is what he said. He said, come down quick. I must be a guest. Listen, I must be a guest in your home today. Why not your home, Sister Mae? Why not my home? Come on. I done messed up all my life. But he was destined to die for what I had did. See, I may be a mess, but I'm his mess. See, he's the only one that can clean it up. See, they say Humpty Dumpty sat on the wall. Humpty Dumpty had a great fall. All the king horses, all the king men couldn't put him back together, but Jesus did. Did you know that? We his mess. And that's what we are. The Bible says we are filthy, a filthy mess. But we his mess. And only he can clean it up. Sometimes I hear people say, I'm not going to church because I'm just not ready yet. And I don't want to play with God. Let me cut the apron string on that. You can't get you ready. You can't clean up what you messed up. That's a trick from the enemy, family. That's a lie to keep you back where you're at. That's a lie straight from the pit of hell. You can't fix it. If we had the ability to fix it, I'd love to be at home with my baby. But I can't fix it. Zacharias came quick. Zacharias climbed down quick and took Jesus to his house in great excitement. This brother was glad. And I'm mad at him. This brother probably danced all the way home. But it's always, like these young people say, haters. But the people were displeased. He had gone to be a guest of a notorious sinner. Let me tell you something. They went there with that brother. Notorious meaning wrong. They said this man was a wrong sinner. But what they're not looking at is just because you told a little white lie over here and what he did over there that you saw and what you did you thought nobody saw, it equal the same. There are no little big sins. Stop it. What you do, I'm going to say it like this. Just because they judged him made them no better than him. Let me tell you something. We have neighborhoods right now that some people won't even drive through. And who are we? Here's Jesus stepping through that hood that you won't pass by. See, I want you to know that Jesus gone in the hood. When he went to the woman at the well, in the hood. He was in the hood. Jesus went to the good path. It's not about this, this, or this, or this, because your mind can't even think what he's about. He said we can't even attain what he has for us. That's what he said. I didn't say it, Phil. And if you have a problem with it, take it over to Jesus. Please don't take it over to me. Don't get mad at me. Because I have to give you what he gave me to give you. Then if I don't, I have a problem. And I got enough stuff going on myself. Zacchaeus stood before the Lord and said, I will give half my wealth to the poor, Lord. And if I have cheated people on their taxes, I will give them back four times as much. Family, Jesus knew that the keys was ready to stop. This brother went willing. He said, look, if whatever I did to these people, he didn't admit it just to God, he admitted it to himself and to others. I'm trying to make restitution on this stuff. I'm trying to follow you, Lord. I done climbed up this big old tree. These people done hated on me because I did them wrong and because I didn't look like them, because I didn't act like them, because I didn't talk like them, because my clothes weren't like them. They hated. See, playing this gets too easy. We know how to look sad. And we won't even speak to each other when we leave the door.
Come on now.
Youth, I asked you about 20 minutes ago to come closer, but nobody would but this young man here. And I thank you for your obedience in the orange shirt. I appreciate your obedience in the house of the Lord. Because it's not for me. It's from the Lord.
All right.
Family, I've seen this in my life. And I'm going to tell you how I can relate to this young man, this man, Zacchaeus. Let me tell you a story about a girl that I know, and I know her good. She lived a life. At a very young age, disobedient, didn't want to hear nothing her mother had to say.
Right.
Had a kid at 14, no, 15, pregnant at 14.
Right.
Yeah. Then she got grown, didn't want to go to school, because the kid made her feel like she was a woman. Her mama struggling daily. Worked $6 a day to feed her and her mouth and her attitude because she thought she had it together. Long down the line, that mama had to take that son that that little girl had and raise him. She was already making $6 a day to feed that girl. She added another mouth, but because of grandma and they heart, she took it anyway.
Right.
Let me tell you something, young people. That girl spent most of her life on drugs, looking for love in all the wrong places. All the wrong places. And after the drugs, it became a life of crime. In and out of prison over 7 or 8 times. You're not hearing me. I want you to don't look at this girl. I want you to look at what God will do for her. See, don't focus on that. That's when we get twisted. Because we go to church 2 or 3 times a week. We looking at that girl on that corner. And we judge her. Not even thinking about you or no better than she is. When all you have to do All somebody had to do is go and tell that girl one day in prison, Brother Richard, did you know God love you? Did you know that? How can a God love a dirty little girl like me? How? Children, let me tell you something. We may not like it, but you better listen to somebody, because they have institutions that you will listen in. Don't be raised up by an institution. Be obedient. When I said that young man was the only one moved up, I meant it. Because he did. Out of obedience. And I want you to know this. Right today, that girl is a grown woman and can't even get an apartment in her own name. Because she's a felon. She's a felon. But God has been good to her. See, the devil should have killed her when he had a chance. And guess what? It's over. It's over. See, it's over now. It's over. He messed up. Will that girl ever get in trouble again? She don't know. Will she make mistakes? Yes. We have an adversary, but it don't give you the green light to continue in your mess. Because I want you to know, the Bible says, if I should die, I take that back. I'm not going to say the Bible. I heard somebody say, if I should die before I live, what will you lift up your eyes? Will it be in heaven or will you bust tail wide open? If we get caught in our mess, family, it's a wrap. Like Mary J. said, it's a wrap. And he used to say, just give me one more chance. It's a wrap. You got caught. You might think that this is not real. And you might think it can only happen to me because I'm that little girl. But it don't. I've seen them come out the best of homes. To sit on death row. I want you to know that after 7-8 times in prison, God turned me back. And he said, you're not through with prison. And he opened doors for me to go back in to tell somebody where I came from and what he done for me. I didn't do it for myself. I want you to know that the keys was tired of his mess. He was looking for a savior. Looking for a woman. I didn't know how to go get it. But because of judgmental people, it took a prison ministry to come in prison and tell me that Jesus loved me. I've seen a lot of murderers, people that did stuff. I don't think I'll kill anyone. But I seen people just like me that God has seen. See, we can come out the furnace. What my sister tell, and we don't even smell like the smoke. Family, God is real. This is not a play thing. This is serious. This is very serious. And to be real about it is crucial right now. But all you have to do is look around you. Look at the generation. He said a generation will come up. Look at it. Look at the storm. This is a hailstorm right now in New York. We're living in crucial times, family. It's time to quit patty-cake and playing this thing. Not for my sake. Don't even pay attention to me, but for your own sake. I want you to know that when Zacchaeus had confessed and repented for his wrongdoing. Jesus looked at him. He was forgiven. See, it's deliverance in the house as well as salvation. If you want it, Jesus responded salvation has come in this house today. He didn't say out there on the street where the people was hating on Zacchaeus. He said, in this house today. I didn't say it. He said it. The Bible said it. He said, in this house today. For this man has shown himself to be a true son of Abraham. And guess what? For the Son of Man came to me and save those who were lost. Came to seek and save those who were lost. Let me tell you, Zacchaeus was the son of Abraham. Do you know what that name comes? It's seed. Did you know that? I want you to know that. Family, there are certain, Jesus will have you in the right spot at the right time. See, that tree, Zacchaeus, that the crowd, the salvation, the house, everything, Lord, was set in motion. Jesus could have took a shortcut. He didn't have to go through that mess, but he went for Zacchaeus.
Yeah.
See, he knew. Zacchaeus didn't go to him. Jesus said, Zacchaeus. He called him by name. Yeah. Come on down, man, and take me to your house. Yeah. I need to go with you. He said, take me to your house, Brother Richard. Sometimes we have people that look down on you in your one room bedroom because they got one in the hand. That's not good, family. Not only that, it's not of God. Family, I want you to know I've seen two little children. AJ and your grandson, we were praying. AJ walked to his grandmother and that baby was sitting by him. And he held AJ's little hand. Family, if we could be like those little children. That's why Jesus said he's not messing with us like that. We gotta become like them. Can we become like them? Can we get a whooping and be happy and still love? Three days, destined. want to do my own thing. Yeah. You know, a long time ago, Sister Band out of Brother make this, it's my thing. I can do what I want to do.
Yeah.
It's not your thing.
Yeah.
And you can't do what you want to do.
Children,
we're the ones that don't know how to love, the old ones.
Yeah.
See, See, I just told you the children, the babies, love in spite of you going at me. They're going to still love you and be hanging on. We need to start loving each other. That's all he asks. Love each other as I love you. Can you do that for me?
Amen.
I mean, some of the stuff he took away just said, can you do that? Just get this for me. Can't even do that. You know why? Because I don't think like you.
Right.
I think you in the Bible, it said it was some over there casting out demons in your name, Jesus. And I told them because they wouldn't, from heart of faith, to stop it. What did Jesus say? He said, you worry about the wrong thing. If they not against you, they for you. They on our team. Who? Family. What do a preacher, what do a Christian look like? What do they look like? Can anybody answer that? What do they look like? Do I look like I've spent half of my life in prison? On drugs? Buddha, ain't nobody asked you to go. I go, and I know I do. And if I wouldn't tell you, if half of them didn't grow up and have been around me in this church, they wouldn't know. God took a dirty little girl like me. Place me on TV, radio, things that I really don't care about. Because he wanted the glorification. Because it wasn't my doing. I didn't have sense enough to stop. Because it was good and I wanted to keep doing it. And when I found out the most embarrassing thing that hurt the most is when I came into the knowledge of Christ, and one thing scared me when I found out that he resides in us. I got ashamed because I say, Lord, you mean when I thought I was creeping, he was with me? I could visualize him balled up in a fetus position saying, Alice, we don't have to do that. See, I love you more than he'll ever love me. Well, we got to sleep with that man because he's not your husband. And you ain't got the best of that drug because I'm your high. I say, when it comes to God into that mess for you, I was ashamed, Tia. I was ashamed. I was ashamed because that's a shameful thing. But it was too late. I had done it. What really matters is, I got it. I got it. I got it. Now I might take my prescription pills because of my back. And I will overdo it sometimes. Brother Harry, it happened. I thank God for that. Because those things will kill you. And if I'm not hurting, I ain't got to take it. But other things, I'm not going to do. I'm not going to do. Family, like Zacchaeus, I'm tired. I'm ready to climb up to the tree. And I want Jesus to say, Alice, I'm tired. I'm tired. When you're tired, we don't know how to come out. That's what Jesus come in. When you don't know how to love, that's what Jesus come in. When you don't know how to forgive, and I don't know about men, but I know women have that thing about forgiveness. Oh, we forget. We don't forgive, and we don't forget. Help us, Lord, in that area. Because without all of us, let me tell you, this building cannot stand. A dysfunction, it's nothing about Christ's body that's dysfunctional. And if there's one brick missing out of this building right here, this building will be dysfunctional. Am I right about that? We are all a part of this.
Amen.
See, the Bible says that the hand can't tell the what? The arm or feet? I can't remember. I'm paraphrasing. Don't nobody send me to hell. I just know. know what the scripture says. The mouth can't tell the ear what to do, that we don't need you. Stay in your lane, and I'm going to stay in mine.
Amen.
See, that's what causes tornadoes, hurricanes. Seasons jump over in front of each other. And then you got a mess going. We need each other, family. That's what drove me when I came here across the street. I didn't believe that it was that much love in nowhere.
Amen.
I'm not bragging on nobody, but I thank God for faith.
Amen.
Even through my trips in prison, they have been there and never once condemned me or threw it in my face. I don't know what they said behind my back, but I want you to know that they didn't show it.
Amen.
They didn't show it. They love me in spite of. Brother Kevin have always had this spirit. I wish I had a spirit like that, brother. God, I wish I had your kind of spirit. I'm dealing with Kevin. He keeps that spirit. And before people remember anybody else, they can remember him.
Amen.
Because of his spirit. My pastor makes me mad. But I'm going to tell you something. I heard a woman of God say, if you're under a pastor and he don't make you mad, you better get your stuff and get out of there.
Right.
That means he's preaching what you want to hear. See, Pastor May preaches what... He's not performing for me. He's putting something in my spirit. He's telling me the truth, and the truth really hurts you. It's real. This thing is real. If you are under a pastor, leadership, and you're always happy about what he said, you better run. That's the boogeyman. You better take out the family. Because he's not here to make us happy. I think what T.D.J. said, you got to know when to love and know when to fold. You got to know. He makes me mad because he tells the truth. Because God goes through him to speak. I just say, speak to me, since I'm the only one who make mad. He makes me mad. But he even told me the truth. And I need the truth. That's the only way I'm going to get better. And that makes me go to the Bible and see that God really said, I do. Yeah, he said. Pastor said one day, and I remember, I'm going to tell you something. I've been under three fathers in the ministry. Very, very powerful men and women. Powerful men of God. Roger Spencer, God rest his soul, John Walker, and Pastor Baines. When I first started going to Heart of Faith, Pastor Baines said something. It was in the Bible that said something pertaining to it will be, if we keep doing what you're doing, it's going to be, God said that it will be impossible for you to come in. And I'm like, why would he say something like that? Nothing is impossible. But yes, it did say. It said it. It said it. You're going to keep doing your best. You're going to get so far out there. It's going to be, you're going to no longer hear about this. So that's what's going to make this going to be impossible for you. And I asked him about it, and he took me to the Word. So we have to study. I study every day. But I study. Family, stop playing. Stop letting the devil fool you. It's time to shed it down. Or at least start shedding it down. How about that? I know you can't do it overnight. You better start. It's almost over. I feel my ride leaving. So I'm going to sit down. I thank you for your time. And I pray and I hope that someone in here, if it's only one, got some out of this, I'm all right with it.